place in the round of 16 at stake. And there is always that little kind of voyage into the unknown scenario when you've never played somebody before, even if they are ranked way, way below you.
You've got to forget about that ranking, which is so hard, and forget about the scoreboard. So much easier said than done. But in table tennis, these pros, they're so good at it. So good at having that zen, having that presence. You get the feeling with some players they're playing only to win, but with others you get the feeling that they're playing to express themselves as well as win. And Diaz is the latter. There's an artistry to her game.
Yeah, and you see this in other sports too. And I think the thing is, if you can win, great. That's the first priority. If you can win and entertain, that's a bonus for everyone. Spectators, TV viewers, the sport in general.
Yeah. Very similar to Calderano, who we saw progress through in the last match. What she means to her team.
Well, Lam doing a good job of just hanging in at the moment.
It's a very interesting rally, wasn't it? In and out, net recoveries. Some instant table tennis karma, but then the Diaz punch, the knockout. It's a low percentage shot, but she loves to play it. Very good at it.
And it looks great when it comes off, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It always reminds me of like a, I don't know, a serpent striking, the way she just...
Yeah. It's Cobra-esque, isn't it? It's a venomous shot. And it's very hard to counter because... the deadening effect of the punch. There's not much topspin on it. You're coming right through the ball, flat.
Yeah, I think it's one of those shots, it's like it's on you faster than you think it's going to be.
Yeah, yeah. Because you're used to getting, well, returning more topspinny arcing balls.
I'll tell you what, they're producing some hugely entertaining points, these two.
Yeah, their styles are complementing each other's. Which is exactly what we want to see as neutrals. Nice touch there. In the rally, I mean, Diaz definitely has the more devastating power, and we've seen that. In terms of power, I'd say she's top five level in the world. How hard she can hit the ball, not many can do.
So, four game points then for the Puerto Rican to take this opening game. Take it, she does. 11 points to 6. She showed us, I think, enough in that first game, Lam Yilok, to suggest that this may not be a complete cakewalk for Diaz, especially because, as we mentioned, she can sometimes just lose her concentration a wee bit.
Hmm. No, she's shown that she has the speed. And she can anticipate and react. She's got good technique, she's efficient, she's fairly compact. She looked like she was getting more used to Diaz's pace. So if you're Diaz here, I mean, do you keep playing with that intensity or do you slow things down? I mean, we might see it depending on what Lam does. It might vary point by point, but... Oh, that'll help the Hong Kong China player. Straight backspin, long fast serve. Tried the same serve again that worked last time, but didn't make the same mistake twice. Lam Yi Lok. I think Diaz might want to try and engage more directly into the forehand of her opponent. That was what was helping her out in game one.
She does look a pretty organised player, Lam Yi Lok. I missed that one, but she's just keeping Diaz honest here in this second game. Yeah.
She keeps it simple. There's nothing that she does that's like, oh my goodness, how has she done that? But it is collected, it is organised. And when she plays a stroke, she doesn't sacrifice much positioning at the table.
Yeah, she knew, didn't she, Lam, before Diaz even hit that she was in trouble.
It's clever from Diaz to go into the body off the loose ball. Feels like we've seen Diaz play a few more blocks this game, so perhaps Lam Yi Lok has tried to really come up the back of the ball a bit more, not play too powerfully, but just get that quality. Unlike that shot. Shovel serve. I think had a bit of topspin on it and Diaz couldn't trap it. Brilliant third ball flick. Diaz is that kind of player where, well, person, I guess, gives you the vibes that, you know, she never had to revise so hard for her exams. She just found answers.
Well, it turned up and just passed naturally.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nice trick to have that. Well, she's going to have to find some kind of magic to get out of a hole here because it's 3 game points to Lam to level this match. And and just needed one of them. So we did say it may not be quite as plain sailing as many expects, and that's the way it's going. One game all now. So Diaz is going to have to re-engage here, having seen that lead disappear. And to be absolutely fair, it wasn't just that maybe Diaz's level dipped a bit. I mean, Lam Yu Lok made very few mistakes in that second game. I'll give her some credit as well.
She's played very, very well. I mean, for a player who has been, you know, struggling to get past the qualification rounds of feeders and contenders, she's playing very well here against such a high-ranked opponent. 12 in the world, Diaz. Diaz has to try and simplify her game. Doesn't have to be fancy. She has to find the easiest way to win a point. She has to play smart. You know she's got the shots to do it.
There you go. She heard you.
What a shot.
Just kind of dismissed it from her presence, didn't she?
Is nice. She was almost toying with Lam that point. That's the switching. Playing it side to side, away from the opponent's racket. You have to test the footwork of your opponent where you can, because anyone at this level, when they're in position, is deadly. You see that here. A player outside the world's top 100 who can win the point straight away if your server or receiver isn't good enough. And by the way, I should say, even players 200, 300 in the world are still incredible players.
Everything in life is relative.
Yeah.
Isn't it?
Yeah, that's right.
Or Diaz reasserting in this third game. Yes, there have been a few errors from Lam, but this is Diaz somewhere close to her best. Well, turned away in disgust after that service error. To be fair, I think the game had probably already gone, but was still annoying intensely. So five opportunities here for Diaz to regain the lead that she had when she won the first game. And she does. 11-5. And managed to keep Lamb pretty quiet too in that third game. So one game away now. So can Diaz get the job done this game? That was a promising start.
Amazing counter from Diaz. She's such a better player when she's not thinking about the tactics. That's when she can really sort of capture the imagination. A lot of talents get.
It's a resigned smile on her lips there. Lamb as that sped past her.
Lamb here is getting caught off guard quite a lot by the variation in Diaz's game. Tried to rip her backhand away from the table rather than lob there, but good construction from Lamb. Yilok. The longer the rally goes on, though, the more I fancy Diaz. So how can Lamb wrap it up quick in a point? That shovel serve isn't, you know, causing as much trouble as what it was before. Diaz is waiting for it just a little bit longer to see if it comes long rather than racing in too quickly and touching or pushing something that she doesn't have to.
Feels like the race is run all but for Lam Yilok now. Had a moment in the sun, so to speak, when she took the second game, but since then it's been pretty one-sided, truth to tell.
If she gets through this, it's going to be a different kind of test against the Lone Ranger of Monaco, Yang Xiaoxin, a pimple player. It'll be interesting to see Diaz take her on, but still a bit of work to do here.
Oh, that was absolutely nailed. Emphatic way to bring up match points. Still six of them remaining. Absolutely stunning way to finish. Just watch this.
Oh, that is mouth-watering. What a counter.